Welcome to this model. This video is all about the satellite link design. In this video, we are going to see about how the link power budget calculations are made. These calculations are basically relate to quantities. One is the transmit power and the receive power. And how the difference between these two powers is accounted for, that will also look it into. And link budget calculations are usually made using decibel or decilog quantities. And where no ambiguity arises regarding the units, the abbreviation you can use it as dB. For example, Boltzmann constant will be given as -228.6 dB. Although strictly speaking, this should be given as -228.6 decilogs relative to 1 joules per Kelvin. Where it is desirable to show the reference unit, this is indicated in the abbreviation like. Now let us see about the equivalent isotropic radiated path. A key parameter in link budget calculation is the equivalent isotropic radiated path, conventionally denoted as EARP. The maximum power flux density at some distance or from a transmitting antenna of gain G is given by psi m is equal to GPS divided by 4 pi r square. So EARP is the maximum amount of power that could be radiated from an antenna. It is also the product of the antenna gain and the transmitter power of the RF system. So EARP is also defined as the hypothetical power that would have to be radiated by an isotropic antenna to give the same signal strength as the actual source antenna in the direction of the antenna's strongest beam. So an isotropic radiator with an input power equal to GPS would produce the same flux density. Hence, this product is referred to as the EARP. EARP is often expressed in decibels relative to 1 watts or dB watts, and let PS be in watts, then EARP is equal to G into PS, where PS is also in dB watts and G is in dB. Therefore, EARP, the modulus of EARP is given as PS plus G dB watts. For a paraboloidal antenna, the isotropic power gain is given in terms of frequency, since this is the quantity which is usually known. And G is equal to eta into 10.472 FD the whole square, where F is the carrier frequency in gigahertz and D is the reflector diameter in M and eta is the aperture efficiency. With the diameter in feet, the equation can be written as G is equal to eta into 3.192 F into D the whole square. Now, let us look into a problem relating to this gain. So, in this problem, they have asked you to calculate the gain in decibels of a 3-meter paraboloidal antenna operating at a frequency of 12 gigahertz and assume an aperture efficiency of 0.55. So, they have given the values of frequency as 12 gigahertz and that is the paraboloidal antenna diameter is given as 3 and eta value we know it as 0.55. So directly substituting those values, so G is equal to 0.55 into 10.472 into 12 into 3 the whole square, which will give you 78,168. So if you want to specify G in decibels, then you have to take 10 log value of the answer. So multiplying the answer of that is the log of that answer by 10, you will get the gain as 48.9 dB. Now let us move on to transmission losses. The EARP may be thought of as a power input to one end of the transmission link, and the problem is to find the power received at the other end. So losses will occur along the way, some of which are constant. And other losses can also be estimated from statistical data, and some of these are dependent on weather conditions, especially on rainfall. So the first step in the calculation is to determine the losses for clear weather or clear sky conditions. So these calculations taken into account the losses, including those calculated on a statistical basis, which do not vary significantly with time. losses which are weather related and other losses which fluctuate with time are then allowed for by introducing appropriate fad margins into the transmission equation. And the next what we are going to see about is free space transmission. So as a first step in the loss calculation, the power loss resulting from the spreading of the signal in space must be determined. This calculation is similar for the uplink and the downlink of a satellite circuit. So using this equation gives the power flux density at the receiving antenna, where psi m is equal to ARP divided by 4 pi r square. The power delivered to a matched receiver is this power flux density multiplied by the effective aperture of the receiving antenna, and the received power is therefore PR is equal to psi m into A effective. ARP by 4 pi r square, which is given by A effective is given by lambda square into GR by 4 pi. Therefore, our PR can be written as ARP into GR into lambda by 4 pi r the whole square. You can recall that R is the distance or range between the transmit and receive antennas, and GR is the isotropic power gain of the receiving antenna, and the subscript R is used to identify that it is the receiving antenna. Okay, and the right hand side of this equation is separated into three terms associated with the transmitter, receiver and free space respectively. So you can write that equation as PR is equal to ARP plus GR minus 10 log of 4 pi R by lambda the whole square, where ARP is related to transmitter and GR is related to receiver, and this 10 log 4 pi R by lambda the whole square is related to free space. The received power in dB watts is therefore given as the sum of the transmitted ARP in dB watts plus the receiver antenna gain in dB minus the third term, which represents the free space loss in decibels. The free space loss component is in decibel is given by FSL is equal to 10 log of 4 pi r by lambda the whole square. And normally the frequency rather than the wavelength will be known, and the substitution lambda is equal to C by F can be made, where C is equal to 10 power 8 meter per second. With the frequency in megahertz and distance in kilometers, it is left, and the free space loss is given by FSL is equal to 32.4 plus 20 log R plus 20 log F. This is obtained by taking that two value to the front side. So you can write FSL as 20 log 4 pi R by lambda, and substitute the value of lambda is equal to C by F. So that becomes 20 log of 4 pi FR by C. And if you substitute the values of constant, that is C is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. So if you substitute that value, then that equation can be written as 20 log of 4 pi divided by 3 into 10 power 8 plus 20 log R plus 20 log F. So substituting the values and calculating, now the free space loss can be written as 32.4 plus 20 log R plus 20 log F. So therefore, the received power can then be written as PR is equal to EARP plus GR minus FSL. The received power will be in dB watts, where EARP will be in dB watts and FSL will be in dB. So this equation is applicable to both uplink and downlink of a satellite circuit. And this equation shows that the received power is increased by increasing the antenna gain as expected, and this is a very large loss. Suppose that EARP is 56 dB and the receive antenna gain is 50 dB. The received power would be 56 plus 50 minus 200.4, which will give you minus 94.4 dB watts. This is 355 picowatts. So it may also be expressed as minus 64.4 dBm, where 64.dB below the 1 milliwatts reference level, right? So the antenna gain is inversely proportional to the square of the wavelength. Okay, hence it might be thought that increasing the frequency of operation and therefore decreasing the wavelength would increase the received power. However, from this equation, we know that the free space loss is also inversely proportional to the square of the wavelength. So, these two effects cancel and it allows therefore for a constant EARP, the received power is independent of frequency of operation. If the transmit power is a specified constant rather than the EARP, then the received power will increase with the increasing frequency for a given antenna dish sizes at the transmitter and receiver. And now let us move on to a problem. So they have given you the range between the ground station and satellite as 42,000 kilometer. And you have to calculate the free space loss at a frequency range of 6 GHz. So substituting this values in directly into this equation, FSL is equal to 32.4 plus 20 log R plus 20 log F. And R they have given us 42,000 kilometers and F is 6 GHz. So substituting those values, you will get the FSL as 200.4 dB. Thank you.